are very important. Because these are very characteristic, unique to this spiritual tradition. The word kayaka means labor. Is central to the Vachanas. Devotion is there. But devotion is only one of the streets. Some Vachana poets are more devotional than others. And if you look at the origin of this culture, we see two streets. One is the of the militant, monochristic Shiva devotion of Tamil Nadu. And prior to the emergence of this culture, the 12th century, in Kalyana, during the reign of Vijaya, he usurped the throne from the third, the Chalukya king. So the site of this efflorescence was Kalyana, and there are some people who doubt this, but anyway, there's a consensus that it happened, don't happen in Kalyana. There was another site of this culture in Sri Shaiva, and there were great saints which were associated with this, like Pandita Radhya, Mallikarjuna, so that was a tradition of pure Shiva Bhakti, militant Shiva Bhakti. And people say that Veda Shaivism means militant Shaivism. But there are debates about this because there is a very old Agama called Viragama. It says that Virashiva means Vishesha Rupena Shaivati Virashiva, not heroic or militant. So these means. For example, those who believe in this kind of Shiva Bhakti, they hate others. In Palkur Kesavana's Vasava Purana, when Shilada, who is the father of Nandi, tells Shiva, you must send somebody to the human world because Kali has arrived and there are sinful activities there. So somebody who should touch this Shiva Bhakti. And send somebody, such a person, who, if he for a moment falters in Shiva Bhakti, I'm going to cut off his head even if he's my son and even if you stop me. That kind of, and there was later period, in Karnataka history, there were prolonged conflict between Jainas and Shaivas. For some reason, some hearsay, people started believing that Vijaya was a Jaina. And the description evidence proves beyond doubt that he was not a Jaina, he was a Shaiva himself, but the Karamukha Shaiva. This is one strand. And even we have this, and this community called Lingayas have always been very militant in recent history. They are the forefront of attacks on writers. They attacked Mastis, Chidambaramayaka, and of course, I was also their victim for several years. So, therefore, book burning. They don't agree with somebody. And some people said, this is the distortion of the teaching of saints. But if you go back to the saints, you already have it's an extension of that. Not about that. The other is, and these saints came mostly tradition of artisans, cobblers. What is? Cowherds. Washermen. Doctors. Who have a different approach. This are oriented. There is no assertion like in religious devotion. It's the exploration. They don't believe in any, they're not believers. They're not believing, but they're experiencing people, exploring people. And this is characteristic of the spirituality of the group of artisan saints. And what is very important about them is that instead of running away from their profession, they perform the labor with meditative attention. So one of them, either Kimari, Maraya, the rice green, says in one of his vachanas, Kai Vilasa, translated by the first compiler of vachanas, Alakati, he tried to put his vachanas on the lines of the Bible. He translated this as work, Vash. And the great Balagangadhara argues that, see, all this has come to Christianity. There was no work. There was, but they used different words. Translation is a problem. I think better than work is worship. I would translate this as labor is liberation. So these vachanas represent that mode. I'll speak more about the philosophy of Kayaka, which is unique to this school of Anubhava, spirituality. Yeah? I invite you to go through this poem and so we can talk about it. up to Akka, path of labor, Kayaka Yoga. takes note of our card. It is a synonym of the karma. So Kayaka Yoga, contrary distinction to Karma Yoga. Karma, though the word karma etymologically comes from the word kara. But karma, in ordinary usage, doesn't mean manual labor. Even thought is karma. Will is karma. Jainism, even thought is karma. Yes. It could be kaya, vacha, manasa. If you hurt somebody in words, that's also karma. But kayaka means what is done with the body. Physical labor. Karma yoga goes with garba, gana and karma. And when these vachanas were being written, kings built huge temples and gave a lot of dana, charity, to the deserving, satpatras. Who were the deserving? Of course, Brahmins. Agamic Brahmins, to be very specific. By the end of the first millennium, in Karnataka, Vedic Brahmins lost the ground. Because performance of Vedic rituals became very important. Temples became very important. There's no spectacle of temples. So, when they gave these grants, they erected a stone inscription. So they gave the details of the grant. Even a king who ruled three villages called himself a Tribhu Adamalla. He said, this will stay Achandrakaskai till the sun and the moon passed. You want to learn how to boast, you should read these shastras. And at the end they said, this is given to such and such, Vipra, Gurottama, best of Brahmins, belongs to a certain lineage. And whoever takes this away, a lot of treasure used to be hidden underneath the titles of deities in temples. Whoever takes this away, the last portion of the inscription is called Shapashaya. If you spare this, you'll get so many things. And if you take it away, you'll invite the sins, punishment, which consequent on the sins like destroying Varanasi. A Brahmahatya dosha, killing a Brahmin. Shishuhatya dosha, killing an infant. And where did this wealth come from? If you have to give dana, charitable, you should have surplus wealth. William Blake said, charity would be no more if there hadn't been so many poor. So where did you get this money from? Loot. All these great kings, Tribhuvana Mallas, the lunar clan, solar clan, with a whole list of undeserving titles, they were looting each other. When they looted, conquered the enemy, they would lose the Parasati, going to the Janata, and Paradhana, it was looted. So Sharanas rejected Dhana. But it's Parasatya Paradhana, it's not so. Instead of Dhana, they introduced the concept Dasoha. From your own honest earning, could be a cobbler, or a barber, whatever, you give a portion of it to a Jangama, the Guru, mendicant Guru. But it should be ill-gotten, not Parasati Parada. And to earn your living, you do some physical work, labor. Samma Kambanta is Arya Akshanga Magga, Buddha talked about. Samma Kambanta. Good labor, good work. So, your own labor, productive. So, labor is the center of the device. And here in the history of Buddhism, that many people used to become monks to get free meals. And they became monks, then they were quite terrible. When the Buddha died, one of the monks, oldest monks, everybody was mourning, he was celebrating it. He said, "This old man is dead. Now I can go watch theater. I can go watch dance." Father said, don't. Now you do all that you forbid. So, spirituality meant running away. Spirituality meant running away from the demands of your body. No sex. But in the Tantric tradition, they said even the very things that are forbidden can be used as means of liberation. But for the first time, Sharanas of Kamanika said that even the labor that you perform can be used as spiritual liberation and a mind for metaphors for your body. So they don't go to Kavi Samayas for metaphors. It's a kind of what Pablo Neruda would later call impure poetry. In the first Vachana, you see the conflict between devotion and labor. It chooses devotion, it chooses labor. Because I have no time to do your bhajan. Go to your devotees. Do this. This is my part. The next, Father Chanaya, Chanaya the cobbler, his pampa is Adikavi. Father Chanaya is Adi Vachanakar. A fact which many upper caste historians of Sharana movement don't subscribe to. They're trying to fight shade of this. But it is established that he is the first Vachanakara because Basavana himself says, Appano Namma Madhara Chanaya. Kobla Chanaya, Basavana was born there. Brahmin's son, this is the born Brahmin. He says, Madhara Chanaya is my father. He says, don't call me a Brahmin, I'll feel ashamed. I was born of the illicit union between the servant of Chennaiya the cobbler and Kakkaya the tanner in the latest backyard. So this is the reverence with which Vasavana held Mother Vachana. Here he is talking about the details of the labor, how the highest stand, etc. They represent different stages of this spiritual purification. And look at his Ankita. Ankita is not just the name, Rama Rama, but also a whole phrase. Do not be enslaved by the hand-all plague of peg. Arigatti, Gunti, Kariyagadiru, Ari, Nijatma Rama Rama. So labor, if it is performed without attention, it can be a means of enslavement. But if you do it with awareness, it's enlightenment. Then, Karnapa, the animal catcher. So, his active labor takes some constant emotions. And either Kilakam or the rice cleaner. And there was also a burglar. And he wants to do his labor with dignity. In Charulata, Uchakadika, Charulata sees that the burglar has gone into his house. He starts admiring the aesthetic sense of the burglar. The hole he has made is so beautiful. So Maritanda says, if I am a thief at night, that would be a shame to the master who gave me the pickle. I don't want to steal things when people are looking away, the sleeping. If I enter houses when people are forgetful, that would be a shame to my expertise. I wake up the forgetful. Now they will become something, and they wake up and forget. Show them the riches. And bring out my riches. Oh, Father, Lord of Mara, the love God, foe of Mara. And Ramana the cowherd. His cowherd takes some cosmic dimension. At dawn, I keep vigil of Brahma. At noon, I keep vigil of Vishnu. At sunset, I keep vigil of Rudra. After dark, after driving the herd back to the folds, oh, when shall I be rid of this cowherd's staff? No, this cowherd's staff shall not drop from the hands until Vishveshwara Dinga. Gopati Nata Vishveshwara Vikta. So Lord Shiva himself is the cowherd. When he can't get rid of his cowherd's tail, how can I? So there's no escape from labor. But every day, he performs the cycle of Shrishti, Palana, and Samhara. Creation, protection, and destruction. The next one is a street performer. Bahurupi. Bahurupi. And his performance itself becomes a spiritual performance. Spiritual. Entering from behind a nondescript curtain, putting on many guises of the living, I was playing the form of the Lord of all peace. But he transcends the performance through performance. I shattered the amplifier. It means it's all. So who used to have some kind of amplifier in those days. I shattered the amplifier tore up the curtain, proclaiming things living and nowhere in space. I was hearing Naginapa. Another one. Dawning, 84 million disguises is plenty forms. I came to amuse my kinsmen. They do not know the beauty of many disguises. All the splendor of many disguises dissolves into formlessness. So, form dissolves. Form is alaya. Form is display. No, who says? Shakar, nirakar, and kadambu, erudu, swarup, and gadu. Both the form and formless are abstractions. One do ahvana, one is invitation. One do visajjana, the other is dissolution. Ubhaya kudarahita nama vokeshwara. Lord vokeshwara. Beyond the form and formless delicacy is very important for these texts. Last, Chaudhary Anakta. This simile of the boat is a recurrent motive in Indian spiritual system. You have it in Kabir, you have it in the Nishwari. You have it in bowl. But here, it's not a metaphor, it's a real thing for me, it's a boat. When I come a ferryman without a body to the great flowing river, if you pay the price, what's the price? The mind, the grasp of my soul. The mind can only do this. Akashana, Akashana. I shall take you across the great street to the end, to the village without words or words. This child I have. With only Akashana, who has his own name, Sanjita. And his very direct, modern tip for that. One of his vachanas is, if you see a devotee who goes to a mountain and worships the linga there, you take the sandals on the left foot, dip it in devocation, and hit his face 88 times. No, you don't call a chappaliya. So, the Bhagavad Gita talks about karma yoga. Which is the cause of talking about karma? Karma depends on dana and karma. Kayaka depends on dana. And dana presupposes parasati paradama. Dasoha, one's own. But as time went by, Jangamas were supposed to be mendicants. Became very corrupt. There's a lot of folklore about wicked Jangamas. Particularly Maharashtra, Marathi. So Marathi folklore, between the Jangamas became villains. Became the start of accumulating property. But this was a time when it became a caste. But in the Vachanas, when we talk about Jangama, it's not Jangama by birth, but Jangama by character, action. this debate has gone on about the word Brahmana also. People say that Buddha is anti-Brahmana. But the last chapter of Dhammapada is called Brahmana Vakko. Who is the real Brahmana? One who performs, one who speaks the truth, one who screams body and mind. Who is the real Brahmana? And Buddha himself is referred to the Tripitaka as Brahmana. There was a caste meaning, another meaning, where it was kind of a marker. So these are Kai Gochana. Essential, though many scholars who have written about it have paid lip service to it, they have not understood the deep significance of this group of Gochanas, both the artisan words. And most of them come from communities which are now class at the Shivaprakash Shivaprakash tribe or police. I think I stopped because we can take the other ones tomorrow. Yeah. And tomorrow I'll also talk about here with literature which was based on this.
This artist of poetry, what's the legacy after this? Does it come up again in Canada's answers, speaking of these voices?
No.
Because that's what makes these
voices. These labor metaphors appear in a lot of Anubhava poetry in the 17th and 18th century.
Okay, as metaphors.
As metaphors. But there's no example of artisan himself. Like images of nature. A lot of poetry. But if somebody who is a farmer himself, Robert Frost. So, I'm not a person. Because the poetry is supposed to be an escape from labor. To seek freedom, poetry is labor.
We not be offering any threat to the ruling power, because the cobbler has to be a good cobbler. So you have to think within the parameters of your own profession.
They didn't mean to give any threat to the those that be. We always think there should be opposition. But they want to be free now. Octavio Paz in his book, Children of the Mind, he talks about the difference between revolution and rebellion. Revolution has a map of the future. Rebellion has none. I want to be free now. In the name of revolution, he says, 2/3 of the world has been reduced to forced labor colony. Tomorrow, things will change. And this interestingly brings me back to the discussion of alienated labor in Karl Marx. So labor has become the rejection of laborers self. So in future communist society, labor becomes a natural expression of the laborer. But these poets are telling us, they didn't know about culture, in anticipation. They're showing a way of how labor can be liberated.
Also, I think one thing that's happening in relation to what we're saying is that, for example, I mentioned the other day that there's this wonderful chocolate place that there are these two texts, the very sort of classical Pan-Indian texts, Girijaka Jnana and Amrita Mantra, are used to kind of talk about the Gata, the if you really consider the archaeological evidence that these are country areas that feel comfortable saying this, how necessary thought was for every single action. The potter's knowledge had a value we can't even imagine. And I think the post-industrialization, these kinds of labor don't have, we can't even imagine that kind of knowledge and value we have. We can't even imagine it.
That's why I keep on saying we should be in a hurry to impose our own expectations. Mm-hmm. We open to the significations which are very different from the expectations. Listening to the question.
And I think that the fact that there are these two words that you mentioned, the labor of the mind, intellectual labor, labor of the body, and there are two words as we calculate there. Because in our world, we tend to conflate sometimes there's a little bit of fudging, you know, like you say, I'm also a laborer, I work on writing, but that's of course a very different kind of labor from tilling the soil. You know.
But this is the claim that here in Suicide Nigeria, you say even a merchant is working. You also labor. Why only factory workers?
Yeah.
Why only agriculture workers?
Yeah, but the fact is that in this period and later, merchants can talk about their own work and they have a very good language for talking about it.
Mm-hmm.
But they understand the value of being the middleman,
right,
or
they
understand that what it means to travel and take things from place to place, like for example, these merchants who take the saddam from Tirupati and take it to another place and, you know, distribute all of this because of their capacity. And they never think that they're doing the same thing of this kind of thing. It's very interesting. If you have a very, very kind of careful valuation and understanding of what the philosophical component of your work. You know what I mean? The value of it, the work itself.
So, any comments? Yes, the first one has learned not to be enslaved. The other one is a cobra. He wants still trying to run away from it. He realizes he can't run away from it. Gopadinatha, the Lord himself is a cobra. He can't get rid of his cobra. Second cycle.
It's a very important kind of perspective that's opening here, when you're urging us not to just think easily about the propositional mode of reading, and to see it as it is in all its complexities, this embrace of labor.
No, we are free to read it the way we like, but we should listen to it first.
Yes, right.
And we can select the kind of simplification that we need.
Yes. So, this larger maybe our imposed sort of frames of oppression. In other words, these are oppressed groups. This does not, I don't know how oppression, whether this resonates at all.
No, incidentally, I said I belong to this community. But I don't see any kind of anger.
Okay.
any kind of complaint about the caste. And this debate is happening in contemporary community. A lot of elders, they want to go beyond shame and anger. They want to explore their own spiritual traditions.
That's
just his Ankita. Kama Dhuma Dureshwara. So Ankita is his Ishta. So the God who comes to the United Kingdom. Destruction. This poor gods to the creations of this earth. William Blake called the energies of imagination. So it says, get lost. You can't be the means to transcendence. What I'm doing, this will lead you to Kama Dhuma Dhumeshwara. The Lord who reduces all my desires to smoke, dust.
Yeah, I was just thinking that we also have other kinds of praying, like we are reading Ravidas. The Ravidas definitely was talking about dying, and at the same time, we wanted to get away from death. We also have Chokhamela, but Chokhamela also wanted to get away from death.
Chokamela sometimes talks about caste oppression. Like sugar cane can be cooked, situation. Raidas, but there is a need to evolve a poetic space of the expressions of artisans in words. Raidas, Namdev the Pillar, Kabir the Pillar. It's an area of this book. Well, normally people say that religion is the opium of people. It's all mixed up, okay? Not religion actually. But how did the working people of those days start gods? Did they have their own kind of religion?
That's a very hard question. What kind
of religion? They're saying, working class religion. But they were not working class in the technical sense. I'm not saying that proletarian class was not born before Karl Marx. But toiling masses were there. But they never saw themselves as victims. The other day somebody was asking me, was there no movement, upper movement, the caste hierarchy? Some ways there was. When a princess like Meera goes and takes initiation from a cobbler center, something is happening in that society. Someone does say, don't call me a Brahmin. Call me an illicit son of the servant of Chennai and a cobbler. Bhakti illada badava nanaya. Bhakona bhavana, I have no devotion. Chennai na mane bedi de death Brahms in the house of Chennaiya, in the house of Kakkaya the Jada, in the house of Dasaya the Viva. Sakala Burat and Rode Redo Bhakti Bhikshi. And these are the people who give me the arms of Bhakti. In the Bhatra Dum Bhikshi. So something is happening in society. And there have been two ways of reading this book. Let me come back to it. One is to see our own reformation, Eurocentric, or revolution. It's a failed revolution. They were okay, but only problem they hadn't read the Communist Manifesto. That's why they were like that. They're a little less intelligent than us. Three, Gajamaya, Gajamitya, Palayana Mitya, Palagandagara. So it seems that there was one guru was giving sermon in Advaita. And he said the whole world is Maya. And drunken elephant was, advancing in this direction. The guru started.